Hello there, explorers! It's Justin again. We're back at the pond today. Last time, our observations here really made me wonder. Wow, have you ever wondered how frogs can just sit like that all day? Do they even have bones? And today, we're gonna find out. So, let's dive in. It all started with a frog. Oh, and here he is again, basking in the sun, just like he was when we were last here. Hello, Mr. Frog. Mr. Frog, can you tell us exactly how you're able to sit like that? Do you have bones? Guess that's not gonna work, is it? We'll have to figure this one out on our own. Okay, let's try something different. There are two animals I'm wondering about. A frog and a snail. Let's see what we can observe about these two animals to find out if they have bones. As we observe, write down the clues we find in your field notes. The first thing I notice is that this frog's body has a defined structure. He has a head, trunk, legs in the front, and back legs too. The snail, however, does not. It's just kind of a squishy, slimy blob. The frog also has shiny skin covering its body. The snail does too, but on top it has a shell. It uses that shell as a protective shield and as its home. The frog's movements are another clue. Look how it swims and stretches its legs. Those movements mean there has to be a framework inside, something to attach muscles to that help the arms and legs move around. Like bones. That must be what gives this little jumper its agility. Let's use the X-ray filter on our camera to take a closer look. Wow, so that's how frogs sit that way and jump so high. Their bones are literally made for it. But our snail friend here, it moves in such a different way. It just, glides slowly. It doesn't have anything it could bend, like a knee or an elbow, so I bet it can't even jump. In fact, it doesn't look like there's any structure inside here at all. No skeletons or bones, just a soft and flexible body. Animals that don't have any bones are called invertebrates. Insects, worms, and lots of other animals are invertebrates. Our snail, with its soft, flexible body and external shell, lives its life without a single bone. But the frog, with its structured body and active movements, has bones. Frogs are part of a large group of animals called vertebrates. Vertebrates are animals who are all sorted into the same category because they share one common characteristic. They have bones. Each vertebrate has a unique skeleton and all of their bones look different, but there's one that stays the same. All vertebrates have a backbone. Within this category, there are smaller groups of animals too. Mammals, birds, amphibians like frogs, reptiles, and fish are all vertebrates. And we can find them all here at this pond. Earlier today, we saw a turtle. Turtles are reptiles and they're vertebrates. They have a backbone under that protective shell, and like other reptiles, they have dry, scaly skin. Reptiles breathe air, so they mostly live on land, but some are good swimmers, like this turtle. Like I mentioned before, frogs are amphibians, which means they're vertebrates too. But unlike reptiles with their dry scales, amphibians have smooth, slimy skin. They can actually breathe through their skin, even when they're underwater. That's why many amphibians, like frogs, can live in water and on land. They start as tadpoles in the water and then grow legs to hop around. Fish are also cold-blooded vertebrates. They live in water their whole life and use their gills to breathe. Can you see their fins and colorful scales? Reptiles, amphibians, and fish are cold-blooded. This means they can't make their own body heat. Instead, they use the warmth from the sun to stay warm. That's why we often see them basking on logs or rocks. The body temperature of cold-blooded animals changes based on their surroundings. That's why it's so important for them to live in the right kind of environment. Let's look around and see what other animals are at the pond today. Ah! Whew! I almost didn't see that crocodile there. Crocs are experts at blending in with their environment. Check out that scaly skin. Oh, and a goose is just hanging out in the water there. Which one of these do you think is cold-blooded? Yeah, if you said the crocodile, you're correct. Crocodiles are reptiles, which means they're cold-blooded. Aw, look at this cute bunny eating the grass. Rabbits are vertebrates too. Do you think they're cold-blooded? Oh, and look at this little guy. This is a salamander. He looks a little like a lizard, but he has shiny, wet skin. Which one of these do you think is cold-blooded? That's right. This salamander is a cold-blooded amphibian. I don't know about you, but I think we've run into enough unexpected visitors today. We've also learned so much about vertebrates and the cold-blooded animals that live here at the pond. But if these are the cold-blooded animals, which animals are warm-blooded? Sounds like our time at the pond isn't over yet. Thanks for joining me today. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey!